Well, I have to leave a law of thirds so you can make sure you see that golden bough. That's right. Hi, I'm the lone journalist, KREZ-TV, Doc Martin. Well, this book review, we just showed you the Iron Age communities in Britain. And so this guy, Stonehenge Decoded, what a fantastic book, by Gerald S. Hawkins in collaboration with John B. White. As fascinating an archaeological detective story as our time has seen. Now, this was done in 1965. This book is in 1965. And yet, you know, I didn't know if I would really like it, but it was written by a scientist. He's actually an astronomer in America, but he went over this brilliant and readable study challenges the notion that the 3,500-year-old Stonehenge was a Druid temple and concludes that it was actually a sophisticated astronomical observatory, in fact, a Neolithic computer designed to predict eclipses. Astronomers and archaeologists, as well as the general reader, will be fascinated by Dr. Hawkins' account of decoding the ancient monument by modern computer and thus unveiling one of the world's greatest mysteries. Gerald S. Hawkins is professor of astronomy at Boston University and a research associate at Harvard College Observatory. John B. White is an editor and exhibits arranger for the Smithsonian Astrophysical Observatory. This guy actually started figuring it out. And you know what? He actually did all this work until the end when he had to have a computer. And computers in 1965, can you imagine? I'm hiding behind my book. But anyways, it's a true story that he went there, took all the computations. He set up a theodolite, like in surveying. So he had strict angles, and he was there at the site. And he was there the day before solstice, or a couple days. And actually, it messed up like weather like this on actual solstice day. The sun didn't come up 4 days before, but it was close enough that inside this heel stone, where the light would come through, was actually already entering. It wasn't just quite over the center of the heel stone yet, but be as it may, it proved a point. But anyway, he got seeing these little pits on the outside in a little circle that was written, or here he shows in this map about the, he didn't know what they were, but they found out that they were movable posts, and there were 56. That's very important. So, with that and the angle, because not only in one fixed position, but if he stood on this side and got an angle shot, then it coincided on a certain day. If he went to this side and shot, still in the middle of Stonehenge, but on this side or that side, well, he got another reading versus directly on. So, well, that's what science does for you. That's what Citizen Scientist does at KREZ-TV. So we're showing you this great book. There's speculation. He goes into how maybe they got moved and all of that. But his actual real forte of this work was this a plan of Stonehenge 2. Now, I guess it was built in several phases up until phase 3. So, but anyway, back to these 56 poles. Every year they would move it for that, for the year, through the cycle of the lunar. And it was actually then a lunar computer and calendar. Fascinating, fascinating story. So they could predict eclipses. It was very well timed for that. And then they knew about 13 full moons in a year. And I don't know about blood moons, but you know, last month's blood moon was the last of 2021, right? Yeah. Or of this year. It's the last of this year. That's right. So anyway, back to the book. Get the book. I got this from my mama's books, my mother's library. She's also a published author here, and we keep her legacy going. Look at the Golden Bough. That is another book that we have over at Carrie Z Books called The Golden Bough. So keep watching and read Stonehenge Decoded by Gerald S. Hawkins in collaboration with John B. White. A newer and nearer story to truth than you will actually believe. Goodbye. Carrie Z TV.